Good morning, students. So let us start today's class of function overloading and member functions chapter. So that is chapter A. Before going to today's topic, that is inline functions, so let me recall all the topics which I discussed in the previous class, that is in the in this first session. So in first session I discussed on the definition of function overloading. So function overloading definition. So what do you mean by that function overloading definition? It means two or more functions having the same name but different parameters is called as function overloading. The different arguments can be, number of arguments can be more, and the data type can be a different. So that is called as function overloading. And the definition and declaration of the overloaded functions can be like this. See, I'll write one example. So it should have a return type specifier. That is, I'm writing an integer data type, and then it should have a function name, and then it should have a arguments list. So integer a comma integer b. Then I'll give another one integer. So this is also, I'm passing float. So float. See, dear students, there is a disadvantage here. If both the types are here int, it is no problem. But here there is a float value you are passing, and here you are returning an integer value. Then you have to give here type def. Type def in the sense you are converting from one data type to another data type. So this cannot be happened. So here it should be a float integer data type. Means this two arguments are returning the float value, I am telling. Understood, students? So this is one disadvantage associated with this function overloading. Advantage is what? It reduces the number of lines. Okay, students? So now, this much we discussed in the previous class, that is definition of a function overloading and how you define the function overloading, declaration how you do, and advantages, what are the advantages of function overloading, and then we discussed some of the restrictions or disadvantages associated with this function overloading. Okay, students, I hope you all understood. So next concept is inline function. So what do you mean by this inline function? We'll see now. See, an inline function is a special type of function whose body is inserted. See, students, here inserted in the place where it is called, instead of transferring the control to the functions. Okay, so here there is no transfer of the control to functions, but instead the inline keyword is inserted in the place where we actually want it to call. So here the keyword is used is called as inline. So wherever you are seeing inline functions, means there will be a keyword called inline. Okay, students? So I'll repeat once again. You see, an inline function is a special type of function whose body is inserted in the place where it is called, instead of transferring the control to the functions. Okay, students? So then there should be some rules, right, for defining this. So what are the rules? We'll see now. See, the first rule goes like this. Inline functions definition starts with the keyword inline. Okay, students, the inline function should be defined before all the function that calls it. Means definition should be there. Okay, and the compiler replaces the function call statement with the function code itself and then compiles the entire code. Okay, so there is nothing like you are giving the complete code there itself. So there should be a replacement should be happening. Okay, students, next rule is they run a little bit faster than the normal functions calling overheads are saved. means they run little bit faster than normal programs. So these are all some of the rules you should be understanding. So inline functions always starts with a keyword called as inline, and the inline function should be defined before all the function that calls it. Means it should be called, means it should be defined before it is using. Then the compiler actually replaces the thing here. Inline is replacing the entire code. Okay, so then it runs a little bit faster than the normal function call. Okay students, so these are all the rules associated with the function overloading. So next, you should be knowing the what are the advantages associated with this. We'll see. So the inline member functions are compact function calls, means compact, there is no complex, there is a compact, there means there is no confusions. Therefore, the size of the object code is considerably reduced. Is it right? Since you are writing this much function here, it will reduce the object size. Is it right? Therefore, the speed of the execution of the program will increase. If the size of the program is less, then what is the speed? Speed will be what? More. That is inversely proportional. Very efficient code can be generated. The readability of the program is increases. Is it right? If there is a functions like this, small functions is there, means then you can read the program easily. Okay students, you all understood advantages. The inline member functions are compact function calls, therefore the size of the object is reduced. Then if the size of the object is reduced, then speed is increased. Very efficient code can be generated, means the code can be very very simple. Since it is simple, it can be read easily. Okay students, so next I'll move on to the disadvantage. If there is an advantage, there will be always a disadvantage. Okay students, so I'll be discussing that now. The size of the executable file increases, means the size of the executable file increases. Of course, if there is an inline associated with only for this number of lines, it increases. Of course, more memory is needed. If there is a more program number of lines, then more memory is needed. If user header file, it will make a U header file larger size and also make it unreadable. There is no readable pattern in that. Okay students, so these are all some of the disadvantage. What is the disadvantage? See, the size increases, the memory increases. If the header file is increases, the program file length increases, size increases. Okay students, so next I will understand this inline program by solving one program example. See here, this is the iostream.h is what? It is a header file. Next, here you are seeing the inline function. See, this is the inline function. See, inline int cube int of a. So this is the inline function. The function name is what? Cube. And it is returning a value that is of type integer here, because integer a is there. Next, you are seeing a main function integer a is n is there, and you have to input the number n, and you have to display the cube of the this n. For example, if I give 2, the cube of 2 is what? 8. So to write this program, to get this result, you are writing this program. Okay, so here see, I'll explain from the main function, because first line in the program is executed is main function. So here I am inputting the number 2, that is n. So that is entered with a cin statement. Okay, and then it is here you are calling cube of n. Then cursor, where it comes from, here to this function it will come. So here the argument is what? A. So number what we entered, 2 into 2 into 2, that is 2 2's are 4, 4 2's are 8. Okay students, and then you are returning the value to the output screen. Okay, I hope you all understood the concept of inline. In the next class, I'll be discussing on friend function. Okay, students, thank you a lot.